by using a pair of the capacitors and a pair of the resistors to be connected correctly. The one can get the voltage of AC 115 volt from the voltage of AC 230 volt. Here we go, they have been soldered together. Two capacitors are connected in series. Two resistors are connected in series as well, then all of their ends are crossly connected. This is the diagram, which are connected. Input AC here. The output will be a half value of the input AC here, and a half value of the input AC at the bottom. For the easy handling and safe reasons, they are secured by two screws on a piece of wood board, a pair of the wires screw connected as well. Connecting the black wire from the wood board to the neutral wire from the AC power. Connecting the other wire from the wood board to the live wire from the AC power. Of course, the AC power wasn't switched on yet during the wires connecting. The AC position has been selected on the multimeter. Switch the AC power on. Be careful, dangers. This is the input voltage of AC 236 volt, showed on the multimeter. The output voltage of the AC 116 volt has been showed from the meter. It is almost a half value of the input AC voltage's value. So, this is a good device made by yourself. Switch the AC power off now. That's the simple and handy ways to get AC 110 volt from 220 volt or 120 volt from AC 240 volt. This is a DIY made transformer, which has the output of the center tap terminal. That is a metal bridge rectifier. The capacitors, which their combined value is 1100 μF and 32 volt. Putting these things together can make a battery's charger, however no need a capacitor if the charger will be for a car's battery. There are the different for the charger's output of their waveforms, with or without the capacitor. Instead of using those transformer and metal bridge rectifier. These are the parts to make a testing device for showing the waveforms after charging rectifier circuit. The loose parts here will be soldered on this small circuits board. All done. They are soldered on the board. For the convenience, the board has been connected some wires and secured on a wood board. Also, the parts connected diagram is here. This is the bridge rectifier parts combined, which consists of four diodes, and they located here on the board. That is the LED indicator circuits parts, they located here. This is an OptoCoupler, type of TLP3131. Only a half part of its circuit showed, its other part will be showed later. Some of the data sheets for TLP3131 are here. This is the negative, or ground. Two black wires are the ones. Those of two points between the LED indicator and its resistor are the points to connect an oscilloscope, which are the red and ground wires. A pair of gray wires in the middle on the left are the input AC wires, which will be connected to the transformer's output terminals. The things have been set up already. Those are the points connected from transformer's output terminals, which is AC 13.5 volt, primary is from the AC power of 240 volt. A mini oscilloscope has been connected to the red wire and ground wire as mentioned earlier. Switch the power on, then the LED is on. The frequency showed on the mini oscilloscope is 100 Hz. That is right, after rectifier without a capacitor's filtering. Its waveform is showing, the part of sine wave on its top portion, which become a DC, with its voltage value is variable. This is a capacitor with its values of 470 μF and 25 volt. To see the waveform changed after connecting it to the circuit. The waveform become almost straight line when connected to the points, which the mini oscilloscope did. So, the waveform looked like this before connected. However, it looked like this after a capacitor connected. This is the complete circuits diagram for the next testing experience. AC 13.5 volt is input, a bridge rectifier, and followed by a LED indicator. The rest belongs to OptoCoupler of TLP3131 circuit, which its resistors values of R1 and R2 were chose, according to its data sheets, as mentioned earlier. The oscilloscope's monitor is ready, a pair of scopes probes have been set up. The transformer, which supply input AC power, has been connected. Showed 13.5 volt from the diagram. A 9 volt battery connected, which supply the DC power to the OptoCoupler's right hand circuit. It is showed here from the diagram. The oscilloscope's probe on the left, connected between those of two points from the diagram. The probe on the right, however, connected between those of two points from the diagram. The waveforms of these will show how the OptoCoupler react to the input voltage change. Switch the power on, then the LED is on. There are two waveforms on the screen, and their frequency is the same as 100 Hz. The yellow waveform in color on the top is the one after rectifier, and goes through emitting diode inside OptoCoupler. The blue waveform in color at the bottom is the one within the DC 9-volt circuit goes through the transistor inside OptoCoupler. The timeline, or point where the lowest value of the yellow waveform corresponds the highest value of the blue waveform. The timeline, or point where the highest value of the yellow waveform corresponds the lowest value of the blue waveform. The reasons for that, as showing from the diagram. When the highest voltage went through the diode, which emitting the brightest to the transistor on the right, made it saturated, so its voltage dropped to the lowest. Vice versa. That is why the waveforms look like these on the screen, showing such as, the highest to the lowest. Or, the lowest to the highest, etc. The OptoCoupler has been widely used in the electric on the PCB related, the one of the popular functions is as the regulated feedback circuit. Although it may use as various purposes, its principle of the operation is the same, as showed earlier. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe if you have enjoyed the video. Your encouragement is my motivation.